Kennedy Plaza is in a strange way always transitory, so you're never really there to stay there, you know, or there's no outdoor seating, there's no cafe,
yeah.
It's very strange, you know, it's also, it's a little windy and unpleasant, so most people are there until they catch their bus. And also historically, of course, in the 19th century when the old railroad station was at its northern edge,
Right.
a great building designed by Thomas Taft, right, and then there are wonderful descriptions in the newspapers of how phenomenal it was to arrive in Providence, come out of what they all thought was the most beautiful railroad station in America, and then cross that exchange place, as it was called, and enter the Butler Exchange Building, a wonderful building that was exactly where the, what many people call the Superman Building is now,
Yeah.
the, you know, and you could have had a passage, you go, could go right through the center and then cross Westminster, and you would then continue your pedestrian path through the old arcade. And so it was quite an impressive setup, and that's much described in the newspapers at the time, how beautiful that square was, and it made a lot of sense because you had business buildings facing you when you came out, and then you had City Hall on the right and the courthouse on the left, and they were sort of facing each other. It's like a standoff, it's like high noon, you know, they're sort of hoop links first, you know, they're facing each other, which I think is great, so the law is looking at City Hall, and of course, you know, if, with Providence's history, of course, that's, you know, it, years ago it was certainly needed, you know, and so that's a very interesting urbanistic setup. So by removing that railroad station, which was not by design, right, that old railroad station by Thomas Taft for a short time coexisted with Union Station, and then mysteriously burned down one night in 1896 or something. But when that removed, they built that artificial hill to lift it up, which is a great feat
of
engineering.
They lifted the building as
the railroad station. No, they built a hill and then put the new railroad station on top so that the tram cars could go underneath
right.
up to Smith Hill. And what I like is something that Providence architects have often done. There's sort of a bit of a memory in the entrance pavilion to the skating rink, which maybe was designed by William Warner, who did the river relocation, I'm quite sure. But it has these two towers and a bit of a sort of octagonal form there and a little bit of a curve, and it's it looks like a small version of the facade of the old railroad station by Thomas Taft, which was there, you know.
The one that burned down?
The one that burned down. So it's a really nice memory in roughly the same location. I really like Kennedy Plaza, but I never spend any time there.
But
Kennedy Plaza is always full of people, yeah.
Right.
But if they had a side that would face west or south, they could probably have a cafe there, but they don't have. The main facades
That's
face...
True.
You know, City Hall faces east, and the main facade of the business faces north, so it's always cool there and always shady, and so that's a bit of an issue. Well, since you asked about Germany, you know, the mentalities there and the way the economy works is so different in European cities, where inner cities are still the magnet for businesses in most cases, so there are many more people, many more potential customers, so you can do much more with a square such as this, and you would have enough... customers to actually have cafes going and restaurants and wine bars and so on, whereas we all go elsewhere for that purpose, and downtown shopping is not a huge quantity at the moment, there's very little going on, so things will change. I mean, the arcade is going to reopen in the spring with restaurants and these little loft spaces there, mini lofts or whatever they call them, and so more people will live there, and maybe more is happening. I'm quite happy that Westminster Street has come as far as it has, so I think there's still hope that one day Kennedy Plaza would look better, but I think it's probably still going to be the hub for transportation,
yeah.
right? That's you know, most European cities have much better functioning central spaces in their cities than we do. That's just an American mid-sized town phenomenon that hasn't been, that's, you know, since urban renewal and the flight of people to the suburbs and so on, that has something that we haven't been able to reverse. You have a few cities where it works, in San Francisco and New York City and Chicago and so on, but most of them look like Providence, so they're fairly empty in the center, and that's very hard to reverse quickly. So I think if you move the traffic away, or the bus traffic away from the center of Kennedy Plaza to the periphery, I think it would be very confusing for people who want to switch between buses, or who arrive on a Bonanza bus or Peter Pan from elsewhere and want to find their way. and much further to walk between different buses. It would take away probably the potential of having a little bar or restaurant or hot dog stand in the center, because people would be so dispersed, and I think the center would still not be inhabited by anybody, because it's, as I said, it's sort of windswept and fairly cool and overshadowed most of the time.
Yeah.
So, but I've, you know, I love going to Haven Brothers, which is there at night. And so there is life coming, and maybe things are evolving more. And I think this is a great city. It might happen and turn around, and then Kennedy Plaza could become the new center. I think when we had our short episode of Occupy, Burnside Park, you know, that was one of those moments, and I think some critics wrote about it, where homeless people and mostly young protesters, sometimes also older protesters, mixed in a somewhat constructive fashion, you know. I think that's really interesting.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it can happen, and there have been festivals down there, and races running is a big thing. They sometimes start over there, and so you have tents and, you know, things going on. So I think there's great potential, and when the ice rink is working, that's a great draw. And so, I think it would be terrific if we could do more with that space.